positive news on the future of the Harley-Davidson plant in York. News 8 was first to report on News 8 at 5 today that the governor of Kentucky says the chances of his state winning the Harley-Davidson plant and moving it to Kentucky have been significantly diminished. Governor Steve Beshear's statement says, and I'm reading now, "Until now, we had been encouraged by the possibility of Harley coming to Kentucky. However," quote, "with the recent union vote and published reports, it appears our opportunity is significantly diminished." News 8 later spoke with Governor Beshear's spokeswoman by telephone.
"We're not saying that we're giving up, but we are just acknowledging that York may have has an advantage. They've already got their workers there. They know the process, and they've worked with the management before. So we know it's going to be an uphill battle. And we're not saying that we're going to quit, but we're just recognizing that it may not come through."
Now, News 8 is not aware of any union vote being taken here in York County, but we do know that tomorrow the International Association of Machinists Union, representing workers here at Harley, will be presenting to their rank and file the latest contract proposal from Harley-Davidson that will be voted on come December 2nd. Meanwhile, we had a chance to talk to some York Harley workers tonight to get their reaction to the governor's comments.
"I hope that is true. I value my job. I'm a good worker, and I hope that it stays."
Juanita has worked at Harley-Davidson in York for 18 years as a material handler. She'll be among the machinist union workers anxious to hear details of a proposed new labor agreement.
"Gave me a good feeling. I mean, there's something going on here we don't know about."
Bob Ziegler is a welder who's worked for Harley for 21 years. But before coming here, the Spring Grove man worked at Caterpillar in York, another big company that shut down in the 1990s under what Ziegler says were somewhat similar circumstances.
"Just like Caterpillar, you didn't know. You didn't know for sure what was going to happen. So,
you think that's likely to sway votes in favor of accepting the contract?"
It probably will. Probably will.
When Ziegler goes to the union meeting to hear details of the new Harley contract, he says he and nearly 2,000 fellow workers know what's at stake. Accepting or rejecting the company's offer could mean keeping the York plant here or seeing it shut down and moved to Kentucky.
"I just hope that the right choices are made, that Harley can stay in York County. I'm sure we're going to have to take some cuts, but hopefully it won't be too bad."
Now, so far, York union leaders have not returned our calls to react to the Kentucky governor's comments. But one thing we do not know, again, is whether his comments also mean that the union will be recommending that the rank and file accept this contract offer from Harley. Again, their vote on the contract is set for December 2nd at the York Fairgrounds. That's the story for now. Some significant developments today, Janelle, in this story. Now back to you.
All right. Thank you, Ron.